In this part of the neurocomputers and deep learning course related to associative memory, we will examine how to implement interpolative associative memory using feedforward neural networks as linear associators. We will examine two cases, which are orthonormal input patterns and linearly independent input patterns. First, we will consider linear associators for orthonormal patterns. It is quite easy to implement interpolative associative memory when the set of input memory elements UK, the set of patterns UK, constitutes an orthonormal set of vectors. That is, if we take any pattern UI and UJ from the set, then the transpose of the UI vector multiplied by UJ, so this is corresponding to the inner product of these two vectors, it results in 1 if I is equal to J, and it is 0 if they are different vectors in the set. If they are the same vector, this inner product results in 1, otherwise it results in 0, where T denotes transpose. By using Kronecker delta, we can write simply UI vector U transpose UJ is equal to Kronecker delta IJ. By definition of the Kronecker delta, if I and J are same, then this is equal to 1, otherwise it is 0, so it is corresponding to this part of given equation. So this expression can be represented by the Kronecker delta. The mapping function phi u defined below may be used to establish an interpolative associative memory, such that the mapping phi on the vector u, u is element of Rn, equal to w transpose, w is a matrix multiplied by u, where w is the summation of the outer products of the patterns uk, yk. These are the pairs in the association. Here, the symbol, this one, is used to denote outer product of vectors. X is element of Rn and Y is element of Rn, which is defined as the outer product of UK and YK is equal to UK multiplied by YK transpose, which is equal to also YK UK transpose, and then transpose. This is resulting in a matrix of size n by n. While we are applying on U, we are using the transpose of the matrix W. By defining matrices U and Y, where U is a matrix in which each column is corresponding to one of the U part of the association. Here we have vectors of space Rn and we have k of them. So this is a matrix having n rows and k columns. And Y is the matrix. Here each Y is of size m. It's a vector in Rm and we have k of them. So this is a matrix having m rows and k columns. If u and y are defined in this way, the weight matrix can be formulated as weight matrix transpose is equal to this y matrix multiplied by transpose of the u matrix defined here. If the network is going to be used as auto-associative memory, we have y is same as u. So here as y, we are using the same u. In that case, the W matrix becomes such that W transpose is equal to u, this matrix, multiplied by the transpose of the matrix U. For a function phi on U to constitute an interpolative associative memory, it should satisfy the condition when one of the UR, which is the U part of the stored association, is applied as input, then the mapping results in the corresponding Y part of the association for R from 1 to K. We can check it simply as UR is applied and the mapping phi is equal to weight transpose UR, which is equal to, instead of this weight transpose, we can write Y U transpose. It was defined in this way. So, since the set UK is orthonormal, we have Y U transpose, this is the weight transpose, multiplied by UR, this is the applied pattern. It results in summation K, Kronecker delta KR, multiplied by YK, which is equal to YR. You can check this one by using the weight formula and then what's going on if we are using UR. Remember that U is the matrix such that each column is corresponding to the one of the stored pattern. And here we have transpose and here we have UR. Because of this transpose, we are taking the inner product of each column vector with UR. And remember that the stored patterns are orthonormal. So among all these patterns in the U matrix, only one of them will result in 1, which is the column corresponding to UR, and all the others will result in 0. Only for the column UR, the inner product is 1. For all the others, is equal to 0. So we can write it as summation of k, for each k we are considering the input patterns, only when k is, here the pattern is same as r, Kronecker delta has value 1, and for that one we are multiplying with yk, because of that only when k is equal to r this multiplication will be done, for all the others this is 0. So this becomes YR, which results in the mapping UR is equal to Y U transpose UR, which is equal to YR as we desired. Remember that weight transpose is defined as Y U transpose, and Y U transpose UR is equal to YR. Furthermore, if an input pattern U equal to UR plus some distortion different than the stored patterns is applied as input to the network. This is one of the stored patterns, but we distort it and we are applying the resulting vector as input. Then we obtain phi U is equal to weight transpose UR plus epsilon, this is the applied input, this is matrix, and here we have two vectors of size n. So we multiply weight first with this U, and then we multiply weight with this epsilon vector. Using equation, this one, this part results in YR, and then as a second term, we will have W transpose epsilon. And let's call this one epsilon R. Therefore, we have the mapping on U is equal to YR plus epsilon R. So this is in the required form. If the input is somehow distorted, we obtain an output which is close to YR, but somehow distorted. And here notice that epsilon r is equal to this term, which is W transpose epsilon. Such a memory can be implemented by using M neurons, each having N inputs as shown in this figure. Here we have input layer. The patterns are applied, and here the connections are represented by W. We have M neurons. For each one, this connection vector is corresponding one column of the matrix W. This is the first column of the matrix. So this connection ways constitutes a vector which is corresponding to the first column of the matrix W. The weights here constitutes the second column of the W, so it goes this way. This is the linear associator made of neurons. Here we apply the input at the input layer, and we observe what is the output at the output layer. When we apply a U pattern here, we are expecting to observe, to obtain the corresponding Y pattern at the output. However, this actual output corresponding to the vector X may be somehow different than the desired output Y. The connection weights of neuron I here is assigned value WI, which is the ith column vector of matrix W. Here each neuron has a linear output transfer function FA equal to A. We are applying the output function F on A and we obtain A. Now we will consider general case for linear associators. Until now, we have investigated the use of linear mapping by UT as associative memory, which works well when the input patterns are orthonormal. In the case the input patterns are not orthonormal, the linear associator cannot map some input patterns to desired output patterns without error. In the following, we will investigate the conditions necessary to minimize the output error for the exemplar patterns. Remember that U was the matrix made of the input patterns from 1 to K. Each one is a vector of Rn. And here we have the corresponding Y vectors. Each column is a vector of space Rm. For a given set of exemplars, mu k, which is a pair of uk yk, where uk is element of Rn and yk is element of Rm, k from 1 up to capital K. Our purpose is to find the linear mapping A star among all possible mappings from Rn to Rm such that A star is the one minimizing the summation on k, summation of distances between the vector yk and a multiplied by uk, where this symbol is chosen as Euclidean norm. So we are looking for all possible A matrices. Among them, we are trying to find out a matrix such that the difference between the pattern yk and A multiplied by uk and summation on k is minimal. The problem may be reformulated by using the matrices U and Y. So we are trying to find a matrix A star such that A is the one minimizing the distance between the Y matrix and A multiplied by U matrix. The pseudo inverse method, based on least squares estimation, provides a solution for the problem in which A star is determined as A star is Y matrix multiplied by U plus, where U plus is pseudo inverse of U. The pseudo-inverse U plus is a matrix satisfying the condition U plus multiplied by U is equal to identity matrix. Here one is representing identity matrix. A perfect match is obtained by using A star equal to Y U plus. U plus is the pseudo inverse of U. Since A star U is equal to, instead of A star, we have Y U plus. This is the pseudo inverse of U, and we have U here. By definition, this is equal to identity matrix. Y multiplied by the identity matrix is equal to Y, resulting in no error due to the fact Y minus A star U is equal to zero matrix. Remember that pseudo inverse multiplied by the matrix U is equal to identity. In the case the input patterns are linearly independent, that is, none of them can be obtained as a linear combination of others, then matrix U plus satisfying this equation can be obtained by applying the formula given here. This is saying that pseudo inverse of U is equal to U transpose U, the inverse, multiplied by U transpose. If the columns of the matrix U are linearly independent, in that case we have an inverse of U transpose U. That inverse multiplied by U transpose can be used as pseudo inverse. Notice that for the input patterns, which are the columns of the matrix U, to be linearly independent, the number of columns should not be more than the number of rows. That is, K, the number of patterns to be remembered, is less than equal to N. This is the dimension of the vectors in U. Otherwise, U transpose U will be singular and no inverse will exist. The condition K is less than N means that the number of entries constituting the patterns restricts the capacity of the memory. At most, N patterns can be stored in such a memory. This memory can be implemented by a neural network for which W transpose is equal to Y U pseudo inverse. The desired value YK appears at the output of the network as XK here, when UK is applied as input to the network. And the weight here is calculated according to this formula. Each column of the weight matrix W corresponds to the weight vector of each neuron here in the network. The desired value YK appears at the output of the network as XK when UK is applied as input to the network. XK is equal to W transpose UK as explained previously for the orthonormal case. Remember that the output function for each neuron is chosen as linear function. So whatever the activation calculated here, it transmits that activation as the output. Remember that the inverse of the input U is defined as the inverse of the U transpose U multiplied by U transpose. Notice that for the special case of orthonormal patterns that we examined previously, we have U transpose U is equal to 1. That results in the pseudo inverse, which is in the form U pseudo inverse is equal to U transpose. Here U transpose U is equal to identity, so inverse is identity for the orthonormal case, so U pseudo inverse becomes U transpose as given here. And therefore, weight transpose is equal to Y U pseudo inverse becomes Y U transpose as we have derived previously.